FC Bayern Basketball-Fans, herzlich willkommen zu unserer neuen BayWa Game Day Show. Schön, dass ihr wieder am Start seid. Nach unserer Dreier-Siegesserie, die die Jungs hier aufs Parkett gelegt haben, freuen wir uns natürlich total, dass wir jetzt am Freitag den nächsten großen Gegner in der Euroleague am Start haben, Lyon Villeurbanne. Da reden wir später auch noch drüber. Aber am Anfang werde ich natürlich erstmal unseren Gast ganz herzlich willkommen heißen und unseren brandneuen Neuzugang, DJ Seely. What's up, DJ?
How you doing?
Good, thank you. How has been Munich so far for you? You already said you didn't get to.
Yeah, I didn't really get a chance to explore everything, but it's cold. It's cold.
You're like, yeah, it's really cold. I know, you got the first snow too.
Yeah. So it's a little bit colder than Spain, but it's not bad so far.
And did you get a chance to at least, let's say, mentally settle at least? Because at least to us, it felt like a really last minute transfer here.
No, I didn't get a chance yet. But it's, you know, like day by day, it's starting to slow down a little bit.
Yeah. So I already said to us, it felt like a last minute transfer. Mm-hmm. How was it for you? Who got in touch with you? How does these processes
Well, my agent did, so, you know, usually they tell you about everything that's going on. So he just told me, like, be prepared within the next couple of days to leave. So, I mean, I still had to work out, you know, with the team. Mm-hmm. So we still had practices and stuff. So it was, like, super last. I mean, I had to pack the whole house up in basically one day. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, get on a plane and do testing and everything. Yeah.
Went very well, though, as far as the start looked. What was your first impression of the team, of the coaches? How did you get here?
It was a great first impression. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, good team chemistry. Everybody works hard. They buy into what the coach is doing. The locker room is great. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't so bad of a, you know, of a transition. You know, sometimes you got, you know, different type of style of team.
Yeah.
That is uneasy, but this one, you know, this team is great. Everybody's great.
You mentioned the locker room. Where are you located in the locker room? Where are your neighbors?
So I'm like in the middle of the locker room.
You got like a chair in the middle?
No, I mean, like, you know, because, all right, so the locker room spreads like this, mm-hmm. and I'm kind of like right in the middle here. So I'm next to Paul.
Okay.
And yeah. So
is Paul a good locker room?
Paul and Robin is next to me. Yeah. Yeah, great.
They're taking good care of
you?
Yeah,
great.
So, yeah, first game went under the motto, no practice, no problem. How was that for you?
It was difficult. Just,
Oh, was it, though?
Yeah, it was, because it was, I mean, okay, offensively, no, but defensively and, like situation-wise, yes. So it was tough, you know. The communication, because, you know, we got different calls on my old team, mm-hmm. and now we have obviously new calls here. And in one day, it's kind of hard to pick everything up at the same time. But, you know, in the life of basketball, there's no excuses. So nobody sees that. They just see, you know, what they see. So just the call, you know, the calls and the chemistry and communication with my teammates was a little bit difficult the first game.
Well, but you still made it all the way up to top scorer, so what's your secret here? No practice? Did you negotiate that with coach? No practice for you season?
That'd be great. No, but it was kind of a last minute thing. I just, you know, went over the plays before the game and the morning before the game. Mm-hmm. So in shoot around, we went over the plays. So I kind of figured where I would get my spots at during the morning practice. And, yeah, that was basically it.
All right. We kind of fixed a little video for you, so let's just look at your first escape together again. yeah. Hopping a whip and I'm out. I need so much I can't count. Oh, and I don't need no college. I'm getting stupid amounts, ayy. Hop in a whip and I'm out. I need so much I can count. Oh, and I don't need no college, cause I'm getting stupid amounts. Yeah, I'm getting stupid amounts, ayy. So much that I'm losing the counts, ayy. I'm a young boss in my state, yeah. So I gotta stay in my town, ayy. So So it went pretty well, right?
Yeah, that was nice.
After the Göttingen game, the first BBL one, you said in the interview, if coach asks you to shoot, you're going to shoot. If coach is going to ask you to defend hard, that's what you're going to do. So what type of player would you describe yourself as?
As an all-around player. Hmm. So, you know, from everything, from pick and roll to, you know, creating for others, to creating for myself, mm-hmm. to playing defense, you know, hustle plays, whatever is needed at the time. I never really see myself as like, oh, I'm just a scorer, mm-hmm. or I'm just a, you know, a three-point shooter, or just a pick and roll player. It's kind of like everything in one, and I try to be well-rounded so that the defender doesn't know what I'm gonna do. Maybe one time he goes under and I shoot it. Maybe the next time, you know, plays a different way and they overhelp and I kick it to my teammate. A lot of scorers have trouble with passing the ball, as you know, but for me it's not an issue. It's I feel like I can make the right read 80 to 90% of the time.
Very nice. We also saw a couple of scenes from the game against NBC, which was a game where you guys started a little, let's say, slower into. Mm-hmm. What happened there and what, you know, what was the switch to actually overcome this 15-0 run they had?
Well, they started out well. They started out really well. Mm-hmm. They hit a lot of shots in the first half. So, I mean, it was a little bit of us not playing aggressive, but then we tweaked it and we started playing aggressive and then just making the right read on defense and taking care of the roll, because they was picking and rolling and hitting the roll, man. So we took care of that, and then we, you know, we climbed back and ended up eventually winning. Hmm. Yeah.
And I guess you also got to show your skills in being an all-around player, and all-around is my buzzword now too, because you've been all-around in terms of teams as well. Mm-hmm. I checked your chronicles, Serbia, Spain, in the U.S. at home as well, mm-hmm. Turkey, Lithuania, Israel and Germany, mm-hmm. So, and this is not a trick question. What was your favorite stance so far? Maybe cultural-wise.
So like the fans?
Or no, like, as in like the place.
Oh, okay, so like city-wise.
Yeah.
City-wise, I would say Gran Canaria was a nice city, mm-hmm. because it was a beach. So it's like a different atmosphere.
Beach is always a win,
yeah,
I guess.
Yeah. So it's like a different atmosphere. So mm-hmm. that was a great city. Tel Aviv, of course, is a great city.
Yeah.
With great weather. And it's also like a beach, yeah. like by the water.
So it's the beaches.
Yeah, it's the beaches. So.
And culture-wise, maybe?
Culture-wise? It's so hard because every culture is different.
Yeah.
So everything, like every different culture, I like certain things about mm-hmm. that culture. So it's hard for me to say like a specific one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's going to be a lot you have to learn about Bavarian culture
about Bavarian,
too. Yeah, it would be easier with the restaurants open for sure, but
yeah.
We'll get there. And you've played in the BBL before as well, in mm-hmm. Bayreuth in 2014. So
yeah.
How would you say, or did you even get a little glimpse yet of how the league has changed?
No, I didn't. I haven't really, you know, haven't been keeping up with the BBL just because of our schedule that we had in Spain. And but when I played in the BBL, it wasn't so many games.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't play too many. I don't think I even played like 15 games, I don't think. But it was, the games I did play was great. I loved it. I loved the culture. You know, when that was back when we had fans.
Yeah. Oh, man, yeah.
Yeah, I loved the you know, the culture of the German fans. And they bring a lot of energy mm-hmm. and excitement to the game. You know, they don't just sit. Some cultures, you go to a game and it feels like a show, you know? Like,
really?
They just sit back and, you know, you just play and they kind of just cheer. But in Germany, they really like, you know, they show, you know, emotion during the game, which is great.
Which is really great.
Yeah.
We're missing them too.
Yeah.
Which is also a great transition to our next little movie we prepared. Und zwar, liebe Fans, DJ hat das gerade schon angesprochen, wir vermissen euch unfassbar hier in diesen Corona-Zeiten und ihr habt uns aber unfassbar unterstützt. Und wir haben uns was ganz Besonderes für euch überlegt, um unseren Dank an euch auszudrücken und euch was zurückzugeben. Und was wir uns da überlegt haben, das zeigt uns jetzt Geschäftsführer Marco Pesic.
Hallo zusammen aus unserem Audidom. Eigentlich haben wir geplant und so war es gedacht, dass wir diese tolle Heldenwand, die wir hier aufgebaut haben, zusammen eigentlich eröffnen können. Leider aufgrund der momentanen Situation müssen wir es auf die Art und Weise machen. Nichtsdestotrotz wollten wir es nicht verpassen, euch allen für die, jetzt wobei es fast 6 Monate vorbei ist, für diese tolle Aktion und Unterstützung nicht nur für uns, unseren Verein, sondern auch für die wohltätigen Zwecke zu bedanken. Tatsächlich ist nicht nur die Wand die Heldenwand, sondern ihr seid tatsächlich richtige Heldenfans. An dieser Stelle von der Mannschaft, den Trainern, der gesamten Geschäftsstelle und von mir und unserem Präsidium vielen, vielen Dank für die tolle Unterstützung und hoffentlich bis bald hier im Audidom vor dieser tollen Heldenwand. Danke nochmal.
So yeah, your start into the season went pretty smoothly so far, I would say. What would you say, or if we're looking ahead now, what are your goals in this time?
Well, I just want to be able to, you know, compete to win a championship, you know, in the BBL and, you know, possibly the EuroLeague. Both will be very tough mm-hmm. to attain, but I think we got the team and the chemistry and the coach to do it. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I mean, just overall, just winning the championship will be my number one goal.
And you already mentioned the EuroLeague right now as well. Again, you got the next opponent on Friday, the guys from Lyon, Villeurbanne. Mm-hmm. Do you have any feeling for that team yet?
Well, that's what we're gonna work on today.
All right.
Yeah, because we you know we had the game yesterday, so
of course
we had time to rest and then right back to it tonight. And, focusing on
you're relieved here, released. I stalked you on Instagram though. That's always a really good research base for an interview. And I was wondering, your name is Vitamin D Sealy. So I was, you know, trying to figure it out. Is it just sun, California, or?
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of it.
But, we got the beaches again.
Yeah. It was just kind of a good name. I just made it up one night and. There's nothing special to it, though.
All right. Oh, I was expecting more in this one.
No. It's not too much to it. It was just normal.
No, you're fine. But I do feel like you're into hip-hop. You have been posting Nipsey Hussle.
Yeah. That was one of my favorite. He's one of my favorite rappers. Nipsey, Tupac, and a couple other. Lil Wayne, but he doesn't really rap anymore. Yeah. Before, yes.
All right. And one really interesting thing, you seem to be into European soccer too, right? Mm-hmm. I saw you with a couple of jerseys. That's very rare for basketball players, as far as I know. Plus, in the US, obviously soccer doesn't get the same attention doesn't have the same reputation.
Yeah, for sure. I guess just being in Europe is wore off on me. I'm a big Messi fan, so I like to watch him, yeah.
Oh, you are?
Yeah, but now with all this stuff going on, I don't know what he's going to do now, mm-hmm. if he's going to stay or go. But, I'm a big Messi fan, and I just, you know, follow him in Barcelona for a long time.
That's cool. Yeah. And I saw you in a Manchester City shirt, too, jersey.
Yeah.
So which one?
Yeah, no, Manchester, that one, I just like the jersey. That was it.
That's for the style. Yeah. That's for the drip. All right. You know, but obviously there was the jersey missing of the current Champions League champion. How do you feel about FC Bayern Munich? Just, you know, asking for a friend here.
I'm not hot or cold on it. I need more time to watch it. I haven't really watched them so much.
All right.
So
we need to
give me a break on that one.
Get you into that one. Okay.
Yep.
You know, and obviously our fans really want to get to know you, which mm-hmm. is why now we are about to take 10 shots together, or rather you are, and well, obviously it's not going to be drinking, but it's going to be 10 quick questions.
Okay.
Are you ready?
All right.
What thing comes to your mind first when you think of Germany?
Schnitzel.
Oh, wow, good one. That's very Bavarian, too.
Yeah.
Have you had one yet?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Favorite sports to watch besides basketball?
Besides basketball, I like to watch American football. Mm-hmm. I like to watch baseball, soccer, of course. And that's pretty much it. Yeah.
You already kind of said it before, but if you could win only one title this year, which one would it be?
It would be the, I don't want to be biased, but the EuroLeague title.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's a good one. DJ stands for Dennis Jerome. Does anyone ever call you that?
Well, actually, the coaching staff just started calling me that.
Oh, no way.
Yep. After the first game, they all started calling. You know, when I came back to the locker room, they said, Dennis Jerome is making fun of me. But no, nobody besides my mom really calls me that. Everybody calls me DJ.
But only when you did something bad?
Yeah,
like
pretty
when
much. Yeah, pretty
much. Straight with you?
Pretty
okay.
much, yep. Yep.
Which game out of your entire career would you like to replay, if you could?
Oh, what would I like to replay?
Only 7,000 games to rewatch.
I know, right? I was like, I don't know. Can I?
Oh. I thought that would, like, something be popping up, though.
No, but it's, I play so many games in my career. It's tough. It's a lot of them that I would want to go back and rewind. Can we skip this one?
Okay, we're going to skip this one. I'm not going to be hard on you.
Okay.
Christmas is coming up soon. What cannot be missing in your house?
I need to get a tree. Mm-hmm. No matter if it's a little tree or a medium tree, I need to get one.
Yeah. Coming back to the court, though, do you have any type of pregame routine or ritual before the game you bet on?
Just, you know, putting up a lot of shots, getting acquainted with the rims. That's it.
Your top three on Netflix right now?
Top three on Netflix. Okay, so I just got done watching Queen's Gambit.
Which is so good,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that was good. Mm-hmm. That was good. It got me like, damn, I want to play chess.
Yeah, kind of tough.
Okay, so Queen's Gambit was the one. And then before that, I was watching, I don't really watch too many shows, but I was watching Queen's Gambit. And I was watching Netflix. What else am I watching on Netflix? Give me a second.
Of course. Oh, got you here.
Yeah, this is a tough one. So Queen's Gambit. Then I was watching, what other show was it? It was Greenleaf. It was one called Greenleaf. Uh-huh. And then it was another one. It was like a real estate one. It wasn't nothing big. It was called Selling Sunset.
I don't know that one.
Yeah, it was just, it's like a LA-based real estate group. Hmm. And they made a TV show on Netflix. It's nothing special. It was just something to watch.
So you're not too much into watching Netflix, I suppose.
Yeah, but Netflix sometimes don't have so much, you know? Like,
oh, really?
Like Game of Thrones is not on Netflix. Like, I watch Power. Power's not on Netflix. There's a lot of different shows
that's not on Netflix.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it's about the provider here.
Yeah.
What other activity besides basketball do you enjoy, though? If it's not watching Netflix.
Okay, so activities, I like to, you know, sometimes I got little cousins and nephews, so I play PlayStation with them.
Oh, that's nice.
I go bowling. I like going bowling.
Which is a perfect corona activity.
Yeah. Well, not now, yeah, of course, not now. But before, we're talking about before COVID.
Of course.
Like golfing, so like the driving range.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nick and Wade will be your golfing buddies then.
Yeah, because in California we got something called Top Golf, and it's just like a driving range. You go, you know, you eat, drink, have fun, and just golf.
All right.
Yeah.
Very nice. And the last one, this is not a question, but this will be very important for you to survive in Munich. Please repeat after me into your camera if you want to.
Okay.
Servus Bayern fans.
Okay.
You're like,
all right, one more time.
It's just Servus.
Servus.
Bayern fans.
Servus Bayern fans.
And then say Packmas.
Packmas.
Oh yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Great job, all DJ. Right. I can totally see you're gonna be fluent in no time. Thank you very much for your time,
for your
insights.
I'm gonna be like Emilio here.
Yeah. Und liebe Bayern-Fans, ich hoffe, euch hat diese BayWa Game Day Show gefallen. Wir sind in der nächsten Runde wieder für euch mit dabei. Bleibt gesund und bis bald.
Wenn es euch gefallen hat, gebt uns einen Daumen hoch und abonniert unseren Kanal.